Okay, so let's go over the parts that you will need to build your Arduino Proton pack lights and sound. So as I said in the previous video, everything is going to be based off an Arduino nano board. That is what I'm going to use. That is what I already have, so that's what I'm going to use. I would highly suggest using our Arduino nano. They're very easy to use and a lot smaller than the Uno or other variants of the Arduino board, and since that's what Mike suggests that we use, that is what I am going to use. I got mine from Micro Center. You can get these on eBay, DigiKey, Amazon. Just be careful, make sure you get a real Arduino Nano and not a knockoff, because the knockoffs sometimes do not work properly. The next thing on the list is going to be the DF Player Mini, which is going to be what controls the sound in our Proton pack. It is basically a miniature MP3 player that has outputs for an amplifier and things like that. Also, again, make sure that you purchase the DF Player Mini that Mike suggests in his code. He has links for all of those things in his GitHub link, and I will make sure to link his GitHub page in the description below, as well as Count Demone, so that you can see both of them. You need to make sure that you purchase your DF Player Mini from DigiKey. I would not suggest buying a DF Player Mini from anywhere else other than DigiKey. Because I cannot guarantee that it will work if you do so, because just like the Arduinos, they are knockoffs that are not real DF Player Minis, and you will never be able to get them to work, and you will save yourself a lot of headache if you just buy the correct one from DigiKey. Moving on, you're going to need a amplifier board for the sound. You can really use any amplifier board that is Arduino compatible. I suggest one that's at least 10 watts or higher in order to get the proper sound output. He suggests that he's currently testing with an Adafruit stereo 20 watt class D audio amplifier, and I would suggest making sure that your amplifier is class D. I don't really know why, but that's what you should use. I'm going to use let me bring up I'm going to be using one that I purchased off Amazon. It is a dual channel stereo audio amplifier, 50 watts, high powered speaker. It has a volume knob that I'm going to figure out how to mount that in my pack, as well as an auxiliary output, so that I can plug MP3 players and things like that into it. I'm hoping what that's going to allow me to do is to be able to not only play the sounds from the pack, but also plug, say, a phone or an MP3 player up to my pack, so that I can play actual outside sources of music with that. So you're going to need one of those. Just go on Amazon. You can find a bunch of different variants. Just make sure that it has the wattage that you need for your speaker, and so on. The next thing you're going to need is an LED matrix driver, which I was talking about earlier. This is the breakout board that controls the bar graph. Basically, the bar graph light in the thrower, or the Neutrona one, is connected to this breakout board, and that is how the code and commands get sent to the LED so that they know how to function inside the wand. The one that he suggests using in his plans is the HT16K33. I actually did buy this one off Amazon. Let me see if I can find the link. Yeah, so there's a bunch of different variants. I think I bought one of these. So you have, this is the breakout board for the HT16 K33. You can buy these from DigiKey or you can buy them on Amazon. I don't think there you need to necessarily be as worried about whether or not you get a legitimate one. I think these are all good. I'll let you know if I run into any issues. But yeah, this is what controls the bar graph light. And as you see, there's a lot of solder connections, and this is by far the most difficult part of this entire build, mostly because there's so many things you have to solder and just the limited amount of space that you have to work with in order to get this to all fit inside the wand. So moving on, the next thing you're gonna need is a 28 segment bar graph. I did a lot of searching and did a lot of Googling, and the only place that I could find these online was AliExpress. I will put a link to where I purchased them in the description of the video, so that if you can't find them on your own, sometimes you can find them on eBay. AliExpress does have them. Sometimes they are not in stock, so you'll just have to check, but I will post the link in the description of where I purchased my 28 segment bar graph. They come in packs of two, so I have an extra one if I decide to do another pack later on. Next, you're going to need a bunch of NeoPixel lights, which the code or the product number sort of thing for them is WS2812B. These are all of the lights that are going to be in, say, the wand, the vent light, and things like that. They're really tiny LEDs that are addressable LEDs, so that you can send commands to them, you can change the color, things like that. You can get those from Amazon for extremely cheap. Just type in WS2812B and I will show you what they look like, so you'll know what to look for. You'll also need LEDs for the power cell, which is going to be the blue light that runs up and down in the Proton pack. Mike uses an LED strip. Since I previously used Count DeMonet's plans, I'm going to actually use two LED sticks that are 10 LEDs each. I will glue them together to get the full, or they may, maybe they're not 10 each, but either way, it's going to be an LED strip, which I will show, or an LED stick rather, that I will show you. I got these also from AliExpress. If you're going to order anything from AliExpress, please know that the shipping time is going to be insane and you should probably not get in a rush. The benefit of doing that is that the parts on AliExpress are super cheap, super cheap. I think the entire, the total cost for all of the parts for this build came out to be like less than $100 for everything. By buying it from AliExpress. If you choose to go the Amazon route, you're going to probably pay a little bit more, but you're going to be able to get the stuff sooner. So if that's important to you, but you can buy these LED sticks on AliExpress, and yeah, so I think you can also use an LED strip if you so desire, but I'm going to use the sticks because I just like those better. Next, you will need Adafruit Jewel lights, which are also going to be WS2812B, but they have 7 or 8 LEDs. I can't remember. I think it's 8 LEDs within the one light sort of fixture. And those are going to be used for mostly the cyclotron. But he suggests using one in the wand tip, but I can tell you from experience that I was unable to get a jewel to fit in the clear acrylic tube of my wand. So what I ended up doing the last time I did this was used a different NeoPixel light, because the cool thing about NeoPixels is that since they're addressable, you can hot swap them. So I can use a different NeoPixel and not change anything in the code and it'll still work. A lot of people have joined a bunch of lights together to make it brighter, but I will, when we get to that, I will show you the light that I did use. I did not use a jewel for the tip. You can if your tube will accommodate it, but mine did not. So I chose to use something else. It doesn't matter because you don't have to change anything in the code. It's just a matter of soldering a different light. So you're also going to need a lot of wire. Mike suggests 24 gauge stranded wire. That is probably exactly what you should use. You can get that off of Amazon for very cheap. I think I bought a box of like 4 or 5 rolls of different colors that you get like 30 feet or so for about 12, 13 bucks. It's not really, not too expensive, but just make sure that you get the gauge that he suggests, 24, and make sure that it is a stranded, because if you get the other kind of wire, which is more the rigid wire, you will not have a fun time because you need to be able to bend this around into a small area. So it'll be a little bit harder to solder the stranded wire, but you'll realize why you need stranded wire later on when we get to that. He also suggests for circuit noise filtering, adding an 1000 UF electrolytic capacitor close to the NeoPixels and a 470 ohm resistor before the first LED of the strip. He recommends that because I don't know what I'm doing. I'm not going to do that, and I'm just going to see what happens. If it ends up that I need to do that, I will. The last time that I did this with Count DeMonet's plans, he suggested adding some resistors and things, and it ultimately ended up not being necessary. I think it's just an extra step that you can take. But we will, if we get to this and we actually have issues with circuit noise, then I will look into this and see if this is something we need to do. I'm trying to keep this as simple as possible, and resistors and things like that kind of like complicates this for a lot of people, and I don't want it to be any more complicated than what it needs to be. So other hardware that you're going to probably need, if you don't already have it, you're going to need a soldering iron, you're going to need some solder, you're going to probably need a set of helping hands, which if you don't, I would not try to do this without them. It is extremely difficult to solder things without helping hands. So you can order them off of Amazon for $7 or $8. You will use them for all sorts of other projects if you do any sort of electronics. And they're like, I could not do it without them. So make sure you get a set of helping hands. You're also gonna need some breadboard. In order to prototype and kind of set this up and get it working before you put it in the pack, you can also buy that on Amazon for pretty cheap. And you're going to need some jumper wire in order to use the breadboard for testing. You can also get that on Amazon. I bought all of this stuff in a kit, and I will leave links in the description below. And you'll also, once you get everything working outside of the pack with your breadboard, then you're going to need some solderable PCB boards, which we're going to use in place of the custom PCBs that Mike has designed, because to me those are easier. For someone who has never done this before, it's just a lot more straightforward and it works pretty much the same. So I'll leave a link in the description for all of those things so that you know exactly what you need to get, and I will go through the process of soldering and how to do that. On the code side, you're going to need a couple of different libraries for the Arduino, and I will be going through how to install the libraries in a future video. For the DF player, you're going to need the software serial.h and the DF player mini underscore fast.h libraries. For the NeoPixel LEDs, you're going to need the Adafruit underscore neopixel.h library, and for the custom power cell cyclotron and bar graph animations, you're going to need the GB LED patterns jewel.h and the BG sequence.h. And he also has the sound files for all of the functions on the GitHub, so you can download those and load them onto the DF player. He also gives a rundown of what all the different lights do and what all the switches do once you have everything connected like it's supposed to be. And yeah, so that's all of the parts that you're going to need, all of the things that you're going to need to be able to do this. It sounds like a kind of like a long, daunting list, but it's really not. I would suggest waiting until you have everything. You're also going to need, I forgot to mention, you're also going to need some toggle switches, which you can get these from Amazon as well, some mini toggle switches. I will put a link in the description below of the ones that I use. And you're going to need some push button switches, momentary switches, red and black, respectively. And you're also going to need a speaker if you intend to have sound. You can use pretty much any speaker, but I will show you the speaker that I used because it is affordable and it sounds really good for the amount of money that I spent on it. I believe that about covers everything for the parts, and the next video will be loading the code onto the Arduino board, and then we will start soldering some lights.